Hello my dear students, welcome for today's video lecture of Ganit Pravinya. Today we are going to learn the new chapter in the Ganit Pravinya, that is chapter number 12, interest. So what is this interest? This chapter, this concept is related with what, which field? See, money, the one of the most important thing in our life. See, if we have lot of money, then we can solve many problems which comes in our life using the money. Now, I'm not saying all the problems can be solved using money, but money makes our life easy. Okay? So, with that respect, we should learn the things which are related with the money. Okay, see, to fulfill our basic needs, we need money in small amount, right? But see, other than our basic needs, we have other requirements, like we like to purchase new house, or we like to purchase car. Okay, we somebody likes to start their own business. Somebody wants to go in the foreign for the higher education. Okay, so for these big things like purchasing car or owning, taking our own house or to start the business, we need huge amount of money. Amount of money in huge proportion. So that much amount of money we don't have. Sometimes we don't have that much amount of money. Okay, but we have to start our business, we have to purchase the car, we have to go for the higher education in the foreign, we have to purchase our own house. So what to do if you don't have that huge amount of money? Then what to do? Don't we have right to purchase new car if we don't have huge amount of money right now? Yes, you can purchase the car, you can purchase the new house, you can go to the foreign for the higher education, you can start your business. Buy. If you don't have money, then what to do? We can borrow money. We can borrow money from the others. Like, we can borrow the money from bank. We can borrow money from microfinance companies. We can borrow money from some rich persons also. Okay? So when we borrow money from bank or rich persons or finance companies means the companies which finance companies from like these institutions, when we borrow money, borrow, B-O-R-R-O-W, borrow. This word you have heard in the subtraction, borrow. Okay, so when we borrow money, borrow means taking from others. So when we borrow money, that money is called as a loan, L-O-A-N, loan. When we borrow money from some other person or bank or finance companies, that money is called as loan. So to fulfill our these needs, we need to take money from the bank or from the finance companies or from the rich persons, okay, those who are able to give us money. So those money which we borrow, we take from others, that money is called as loan, L-O-A-N, loan. So this chapter is totally related with this loan, the money which we borrow from others. Okay, now see, when we borrow money, this loan, is it our, are they our money? No, these money are, these rupees are of these institutions like bank and that person or finance company. These are not our money. They give us, right? but they give us, that means those monies are, money is not our. Okay, we have to repay them, we have to give them return. Okay, so that money is called loan. So that loan which we have taken from bank, that loan we need to pay, we have to pay again back after some years. So see, when we repay that loan, that particular institution, that loan, that repayment is called amount. It is called amount. Okay, when we borrow the money, it is called as loan. Okay, the amount of loan which we have, suppose I have taken loan of 10 lakh rupees to purchase my house, that 10 lakh rupees, okay, I have taken loan of rupees 10 lakh. That 10 lakh rupees is called as principal. It is called principal. Means the amount of loan. This is amount of loan. It is called principal. Okay. And when we repay that loan to the particular institute from which we have taken loan, that is called as amount. Okay, so see, suppose I have taken 10 lakh rupees loan from the bank. I have taken 10 lakh rupees loan, and it is decided that I have to repay that loan within 20 years. Understood? So I have taken this loan for 20 years. Within that 20 years, I have to return that loan to the bank. Now see, whenever bank will give us loan and we will repay them, what we will repay? We will repay only what amount we have taken, that only we will repay. Means I have taken 10 lakh rupees loan, same amount I will return them. Then what is their benefit? If after 20 years again I'm repaying same amount, 10 lakh rupees only to the bank, then what is their benefit? They are giving us loan, they are giving us money for to fulfill our need. Then what is their benefit? They should also get some benefit in that, right? I'm going to use that money for to start my business or to purchase my home. So I'm going to take benefit of their money. Then what is their benefit? What is their profit? They should also get some profit, right? So see here. Here comes the concept interest. When I take 10 lakh rupees from the bank for 20 years, when I will return them after 20 years, when I will return the 10 lakh rupees loan to them, at that time I will give some extra amount. I have to return some extra amount to the bank. Extra money. Other than this 10 lakh, I have to give them some extra rupees. That is called interest. So this amount which I will return to them, it includes this principal. Means this 10 lakh rupees plus, because this principal is their own money, and plus they should get some benefit, they should get some profit from me. I have to pay some extra money to them. That will be their profit. Okay, so that extra money is called as interest. So when after 20 years I will repay the amount to the bank, it will include the principal plus interest. Understood? Principal means what? Principal means the amount which I have borrowed, which I have taken as a loan. That is 10 lakh rupees. Okay. And after 20 years I will repay them this principal 10 lakh rupees plus some extra rupees I will add in that is called interest. And this is not this interest, who will decide this interest? Not myself. It will be fixed according to the rate of interest. Okay, it will be decided when the loan is taken. Suppose today I am taking loan, at that time all the documentation will be done, and I have at that time the rate of interest will be decided, how much extra rupees I have to give back to the bank. That will be decided at that time. Okay, so this interest is there, no? It is not upon me what extra money I should give them. It is decided according to the law. Okay, so this is a little confusing concept for you, because you don't have experience of taking loan. But if you ask your parents, what is the procedure of taking loan? In simple language, they will tell you. Once again, I repeat. See here, to purchase car or our own house, or to start the new business, like these things, we need huge amount of money. Okay, so if we don't have, or everybody don't have that huge amount with themselves. Okay, so in that case we can take money from bank or finance companies or any other rich persons. Okay, that money we will borrow. Okay, so that money which we borrow, it is called loan. Okay, so see, loan, when we take loan, suppose I am taking loan of 10 lakh rupees okay, so the 10 lakh is called as a principal. These new words are there, no? You have to say again and again, you have to go in that and say again and again, principal, the amount which we borrow. Exact, suppose I am taking a loan of 10 lakh rupees, that is, so 10 lakh rupees is the principal of that loan. I have taken this loan for 20 years. I have taken this loan for 20 years. This is called period of time. Principal, in short, it is written as P. 20 years, for 20 years I have taken that loan. That means it is called period of time, and it is denoted by M. Period of time. There is not any period of time, but it is denoted by M. Okay. Then this is amount. After 20 years, the money which I will repay to the bank, it is called amount. And that amount is made up of, that amount include principal plus interest. Okay, now this interest is how the interest is decided, that we learn. So see, I am going to draw this concept. If you understand, then all other things are very easy. Now I'll tell you how the interest is decided. See, interest. Okay, interest means what? Extra money which we have to pay along with the principal. Okay, that will also together principal and interest make amount. Understood? So see, interest, what is mean by interest? Suppose I have taken loan of rupees 100. I have taken loan of rupees 100 for 1 year. Means period. For how many years? For 1 year. This period can be 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, 6 months, okay, it can be vary. 5 years, 10 years, long term, 20 years, 25 years, okay. Like home loan, such loans are taken for long term period, that is 20 years, 25 years, sometimes 30 years too. So, I have taken principal loan of rupees 100 for 1 year. Then the interest which is decided, it is called rate of interest. Rate of interest, in short R. Okay. So rate of interest means what? Rate of interest means for 100 rupees, for 100 rupees and for 1 year, how much amount I have to pay as an interest. That is called rate of interest. For 100 rupees, for every 100 rupees, see, for 100 rupees and for 1 year, how much amount I have to pay, that is called rate of interest. Okay, that means what? For 100 rupees and for 1 year, I have to pay rupees 5. So this will be our rate of interest. Rupees 5 is the rate of interest. Then suppose I have taken loan of rupees 500 for 1 year. And rate of interest is rupees 5. Five for 100 for 1 year. Okay? Rupees 100 and for 1 year. Then for 500 and 1 year, how much amount I have to pay? With this rate of interest, I have to pay. For 100 and for 1 year, rupees 5. Then for 500, 100 5 is a 500. So 5 5 is a 25. I have to pay interest 25 for 1 year. And if there will be 2 years, then rate of interest means this is rupees 5 for 100 for 1 year. Then for 500 and for 2 years, rupees 50. There is formula to find this. You don't worry, the calculation is very easy. Okay? So see, just here keep it in mind how rate of interest is decided. Rate of interest is decided for 100 and for 1 year. Rate of interest is decided per 100 per 1 year. Okay? So if the principal is 1000, 2000, 1 lakh, 5 lakh, the rate of interest which will be given here, it is behind every 100 and 1 year. Every 100 rupees and for 1 year. Okay? So while writing rate of interest, it is written that 5PCPA. 5PCPA means rupees 5 per cent per annum. PCPA means per cent. Cent means 100. Century. You know century? Century means 100. So cent is the short form of century. Per cent per annum. Annum means annual. Annual means 1 year, right? So per cent means per 100 rupees per annum. Per annum means per 1 year. Okay? Annual means 1 year. So percent per annum. So rate of interest is decided per cent per annum. So when we say rupees 5 is the rate of interest, rupees 5 PCPA is the rate of interest, that doesn't mean I have to pay rupees 5 to them. I have to pay according to my loan. This rate of interest is given for 100 and for 1 year. But if I have taken 500 rupees, then I don't, that doesn't mean I have to pay only 5 rupees more than 500. It will be calculated. It is depend on the principal. Okay? And years also, period of time. If the period of time is more, again it will be multiplied. Understood? So see, so with this rate of interest, this period and this principal, when we pay the interest, it is called simple interest. In short, SI. Okay? Simple interest. And it is calculated, you know? How it is calculated? Principal, that is P multiply by n, n means period of time multiplied by r, rate of interest r upon 100. This is the formula to count simple interest of our loan. Means now see, if I have taken 10 lakh rupees 10 lakh loan from the bank and I have to pay that for the within the 20 years. Means I have taken 10 lakh rupees loan for 20 years with the rate of interest of rupees 5 PCPA, 5% per annum. Then how much amount I have to pay after 20 years? That can be counted using this formula. Understood? Means if we know this formula, we can count after 20 years how much amount I will pay to the bank. Understood? So see here, simple interest means principal plus principal into n, that is number of years or period of time, multiplied by r. R means rate of interest, okay, upon 100. This will be divided by 100. Multiplication of this will be divided by 100. Understood? So the year will get simple interest means extra money on principal which I have to pay, that is for simple interest. So how much extra money I have to pay, that is simple interest we will get using this formula. And when and if you have to count the final amount which I have to pay to the bank at the end of the period, means after 20 years, the final amount which I have to pay, how we will get that? Principal plus this simple interest, okay? Principal plus the simple interest. Understood? So the principal means the amount which we have borrowed, and simple interest means the extra amount which I have to pay to the bank. Understood? So in this way we will get the amount which at the end of the period we have to pay to the bank. Okay? So see, these concepts, these words, principal means what, period means what, rate of interest means what. Rate of interest is a little confusing concept for you, because it is decided, how the rate of interest is decided? Rate of interest is decided for rupees, per rupees 100 per 1 year. Means what, how many hundred here? 500 are there. Then rate of the interest will be increased, because this 5 rupees is for 100 and for 1 year, but for 500 there will be no 5 rupees. It will be increased according to the year, according to the principal and period of time. Okay, so this 5 rupees is behind every 100 and behind every 1 year. Okay, understood? Rate of interest, principal, period of time, rate of interest, PLR, again simple interest, this formula. Amount means what? Amount, how the amount is obtained? Principal plus simple interest amount which we have to repay to the bank after end of the period. Okay, so this concept, write in the notebook and revise it again and again, say again and again. Visualize what is meant by principal, what is meant by period, rate of interest means what, simple interest, its formula, how to calculate simple interest, and how to calculate the amount which we have to pay at the end of the period. How? Principal plus simple interest. So these and these two formulae, write these also, write these names, write down in notebook, and these two formulae write in the notebook. Okay, after this we will solve the exercise 19. Here they have given exercise 20 in the textbook. They have given exercise 20, but it is actually 19, because in the previous chapter last exercise is 18, but here directly they have given 20. So it is actually 19, but you write as a 20 only, because otherwise you will get confused, because here it is 20 and you will write in the notebook you will write 19. So better write 20 only. Okay, now see the exercise 20. First instruction is for question number 1 to question number 3. In question number 1 to question number 3, write down the principal, period, rate of interest, total interest and the amount paid. Here we do not have to calculate what they have given. They have given in that statements, we have to just identify. which is principal, which is rate of interest, which is time of period, okay, which is simple interest and which is amount. So see, open your page number 132. I am reading question. Pay attention, put your finger and try to get that concept. Before that, I'll write here which things we want. First we want principal, then we want period, then we want rate of interest, then we want interest, then amount. Okay, now see, first one. Shripati repaid the loan of rupees 800 taken for 2 years ago at 5% per annum by paying rupees 880. See the sentence. Shripati repaid. How much Shripati repaid? What Shripati repaid? The loan of rupees 800. The loan of rupees 800 means he had taken loan of rupees 800 for 2 years. Okay, taken 2 years ago. He had taken that loan 2 years ago. That means for 2 years. Now he has paid. That means for 2 years he had taken at 5% per annum by paying rupees 880. Means he paid 880. Okay. So what we call called it? What the money which we have to pay at the end of the period, it is called amount. So he paid, see, he paid by paying rupees 880, means he paid rupees 880, that is the amount he paid. What is principal? Means how much amount, how much rupees or how many rupees he had taken as a loan, that is called principal. What amount he had taken? Rupees 800, correct? Rupees 800. Then for period. Period means for how many years he had taken? For 2 years. See, principal means P, period means M, and rate of interest is denoted by R. For what rate of interest? At 5% per annum. Rate of interest written like this way, 5%. This is sign of percent. Percent means per 100 century. Percent per annum. Per annum means per 1 year. Okay? So this is rate of interest. Then what is interest is not given here. Actual interest. But we can find interest. How? See, this amount which he paid at the end of the period is 880, and he had taken loan of rupees 800, means how much extra amount he paid? 880 minus 800, 0, 8 minus 0, 8, 0. So extra he paid 80. So extra amount is called as interest, right? So rupees 80 is the interest. Understood? So you know amount, how do you get this amount? Principal plus interest is equal to amount, right? Principal plus interest is equal to amount. So 800 plus 80 is equal to 880. This is the amount he has paid. Understood? See, if principal and interest is given, we can find amount. If principal and amount is given, then we can find interest. And if interest and amount is given, we can find principal. Okay? Second, see, second, Anand had taken the loan of rupees 20,000 for repairing his house. He repaid the loan after 1.5 years by paying rupees 22,400. The rate of interest was 8% per annum. So they have given some sentences we have to identify. What is principal, what is period, what is rate of interest, what is interest, and what is amount. Okay? So first we will find principal. Principal means the amount which is taken as a loan. Rupees which is taken as a loan. So Anand had taken loan of rupees 20,000. He has taken loan of rupees 20,000. So that is the amount. Sorry, that is the principal. Rupees 20,000. Okay. Then period. For how many years he has taken that loan? For means he repaid the loan after 1.5 years. Means he had taken that loan for 1.5 years. 1.5 year. How to write? 1.5 year. 1.5 year. Okay. At what rate of interest? What was the rate of interest? The rate of interest was 8% per annum. So rate of interest was here 8% per annum. For this, instead of this percent sign, it can be written as PCP. Okay, percent per annum. Understood? And at the end, how much amount he paid? He repaid the loan after 1.5 year by paying rupees 22,400. Means he repaid rupees 22,400. Then what will be the interest? Principal is 20,000 and the amount which he repaid it is 22,400. So to find interest, what we should do? Amount is equal to principal plus interest. Then to find interest, this principal we have to subtract from amount. Amount minus principal. So amount is 22,400 minus principal is 20,000. 0 minus 0, 0, 0 minus 0, 0, 4 minus 0, 4, 2 minus 0, 2, 0, 2,400. So the interest is rupees 2,400. Okay? Amount is rupees 22,400, which he paid after 1.5 year, and he had taken loan of 20,000. So what is difference between them? 2,400. So 2,400 is the interest, extra money which he paid. That is what interest he paid. Okay. Third one. A loan of rupees 1,50,000 was taken from a bank for purchasing a flat at 4% per annum. The loan was repaid in 3 annual installments of rupees 56,000, rupees 54,000 and rupees 52,000. Now see, first we'll find principal. A loan of rupees 1,50,000 was taken. Loan of rupees 1,50,000. So 1,50,000 is the principal. Principal amount. For how many years? The loan was repaid in 3 annual installments. 3 annual installments means loan was taken for 3 years. Okay? Because it was returned in 3 years. Okay? 3 annual installments means 3 years. So it was taken for 3 years. At what rate of interest? At 4% per annum. So 4PCPA. Okay? And interest. So now see, interest is not given directly, but amount which is repaid, it is given in 3 annual installment. First year they paid 56,000. Second year they paid 54,000. And in third year 52,000. So total how many amount is paid? Let's see. 0 plus 0 plus 0, 0, 0, 0. 6 plus 4, 10. 10 plus 2, 12. 2 come down, 1 carry. 5, 3 are 15 plus 1, 16. So amount which was paid at the end of 3 years is 1,62,000. See here. Loan is taken 1,50,000 and amount is paid 1,62,000. So what was the rate of what was the interest? How much extra money is paid? 1,62,000 minus 1,50,000. Correct? 2 minus 0, 2, 6 minus 5, 1. 12,000 rupees. 12,000 was the extra amount which was paid along with the principal. Okay. So interest is, that is for interest. 12,000 was the interest. This is not. So now see next question number. Pause this video, write these 3 examples in your notebook. See next. Question number 4 to 6. In question number 4 to 6 below, find the answers at blank. Principal, 3 columns are there. It's very easy. Principal, interest, and amount. So in first rupees 4000, rupees 480 interest. Now see, principal is rupees 4000, interest is rupees 480. We have to find amount. What will be amount? You know, amount is what? Amount is what? Principal plus interest. Principal plus interest. So along with this, together they make amount which you have to pay at the end of the period. Okay. So 4000 plus 480. What is 4000 plus 480? Rupees 4480. Okay, that will be amounts. In the next, principal is not given, interest is given rupees 1250, and amount is given 7500. So what is the principal if the interest is 1250 and amount which is paid is 7500? To find principal, what to do? You know, interest means what? Extra amount, extra money along with the principal. Okay, and amount is made up of principal plus interest. Then to find principal, what you have to do? From this amount, you have to subtract interest. 7500, you will subtract 1250 from this. 0 minus 5, not possible. 10 minus 5, 5. 4 minus 2, 2. And 7 minus 1, 6. Correct? So the principal, the loan which was taken was rupees 6250. Okay, 6250. Next, rupees 3000 is the principal. Interest is not given, and the amount which is paid, it is 3720. 3720. Then what? Interest means the extra amount on principal. What is given? So amount minus principal. From this amount, when we subtract principal, we get interest. Okay? 720. Rupees 720 is the extra amount is given. Extra rupees is given on the principal. You see, 3000 plus 720, 3720. 6250 plus 1250, 7500. Okay, so amount, how the amount is obtained? Principal plus interest. And if you have to find amount and principal is given, you have to find interest. Then from the amount subtract principal. If interest and amount is given, to find the principal, subtract interest from amount, you will get principal. Okay, now pause this video and write this in your notebook. In question number 7 to 10, find the interest and the amount. See, principal is given in question number 7. Principal is rupees 4000. Then period is denoted by N. Okay, period is 1 year. Rate of interest R is 12. PCPA. Okay, then we have to find interest and the amount. Here, when these three things are given, principal, period and rate of interest, how to find simple interest? We have formula, right? How to calculate simple interest? We have to calculate here what will be the simple interest and what will be the amount we have to pay after the period of time. So first we will calculate simple interest to find the amount. To find the amount which we have to pay at the end of the period, first we need to find simple interest, right? So how to calculate simple interest? Using the formula. Which formula is there? P into N into R upon 100. Understood? So P means principal. What is that? Rupees 4000 multiplied by N 1 year multiplied by rate of R means rate of interest. What is that? 12 upon 100. Okay. Now see 4000. Now see here, these things are in the numerator. This 100 is in the denominator. So see, in this 4000 and 100, last two zeros are there that we can cut. Now denominator became 1, and when the denominator is 1, it means nothing. Okay. So simply multiply this rupees 40 into 1 into 12. That is 12 ones are 12 into 40. 40 into 12, 12 zeros are 0, 12 fours are 48. Rupees 480. So rupees 480 is the interest which we have to pay along with the principal. Then how to find amount? So amount is equal to amount which you have to pay at the end of the 1 year. What? Principal plus interest. This is another formula. Principal finding amount. Amount is equal to principal plus interest. Okay. So what is principal? 4000. Rupees 4000 plus interest rupees 480. So total 4000 plus 480 rupees 4480. So if we have taken loan of 4000 for 1 year with the rate of interest 12, then we have to pay after 1 year, we have to pay what amount? Rupees 4480. Understood? With the interest rupees 480. Okay. Question number 8. Here principal is given rupees 1500. Period means N is given 2 years and rate of interest is 8 TCP. Here also same procedure. First we have to find simple interest, then we have to find amount. Okay, so to find simple interest we have formula P into N into R, P and R upon 100 is equal to P is what? Rupees 1500 into N is what? 2 years into rate of interest is 8 TCPA upon 100. So let's do calculation. This 2 zeros in the numerator and 2 zeros in the denominator can be cut. Now denominator is 1, that means nothing. Okay. Now 15 2s are 30. 30 into 8. 8 zeros are 0, 8 threes are 24. Rupees 240 is the interest. Simple interest. And amount is what? Amount which we have to pay, it is principal plus interest. So principal is 1500 plus interest is rupees 240. So 1500 plus 240. 0 plus 0, 0. 0 plus 4, 4. 5 plus 2, 7 and 1000. So amount which we have to repay is 1740. Understood? And only interest is rupees 240. Okay? So these two formulae here in this chapter we have to memorize, we have to keep it in mind. Also this concepts, principal, rate of interest and period of time N. Keep it in mind. Question number 9 and 10, try by yourself. Okay? So thank you for today and have a nice day.